We're giving you insider details behind Ela Nordegren's exclusive interview with People magazine. People writer Steve Helling is back with us this morning. Yes. And Steve, we know that Elon and Tiger are officially over. We don't know the details behind the divorce settlement. And Elon made a point in the article to say money can't buy happiness. Exactly. What do we know about the divorce?
Well, what we do know is that there was a prenup that was thrown out and that they figured out something that would work for both of them. Obviously, she's become a very wealthy woman, and she has no problem saying that at this point. She knows that everybody speculates, but she wouldn't give exact dollar figures. But I can tell you it's probably a lot less than it would have been if she had not given this interview.
Well, and she talks about the fact that having all of this money, she doesn't talk specifics, right. But she says it definitely gives her the liberty to travel to Sweden, see right. her family, and not have to work right now, focus on her studies, and more importantly, her children.
Exactly. And I know that, you know, she does say money can't buy happiness, but I think she's very realistic in how she looks at it and says that, you know, she is in a better place than she would be without having that type of money.
So she's talked about future plans, where yes. she plans on living, what she plans mm-hmm. on doing. What did you find out?
Well, you know, she has been studying at Rollins College, night classes. So if you've seen somebody who's looked familiar at Rollins, it's probably Elon. And, you know, she has 40 more credits to go, and she really does want to work someday. She doesn't want to just sit around and do nothing. And this is something that's been fascinating with her. And even while she was married to Tiger, she was going to school.
In the article, she gets into her personal life and her family life right. growing up in Sweden, talks about her parents' divorce, right. but also says that as for her and her children, she's teaching them that it's better to be happy and alone than be in a relationship without trust.
And that's classic psychiatry there. You know, you just want to be happy with yourself. And that's the thing in these 12 pages. You do get the idea that she's gone through a lot. She says she's gone through hell, but she's happy at this point. And I think she's growing into her new role as being a single woman.
You talk about forgiveness in the article. Mm-hmm. Has she forgiven Tiger?
It's a long road, and that's the last step in this whole process. You know, I think there are days that are good and days that are bad. There are times that she gets angry and times that she has moved on past it. So forgiveness is a process. It's not just something that just happens. And she's in that process right now.
And she talks about her children, both Sam and Charlie, how much she's relied on them, even though they're toddlers.
Right. Well, I mean, she had to be strong for them. She's their mother. And that was one big thing that she wanted to get across, that, you know, they helped her and she helped them through this whole process.
She also talks about moving on, obviously, and talks about dating and says she's not interested anytime soon.
Well, I can't blame her at this point. This would be a hard thing to, you know, she's going to have to trust whoever she's with. It's going to take some time. I suspect that, you know, she's a young woman. I suspect we'll see her date again sometime, but not for the near future.
What was her demeanor like during this whole thing? I mean, what did you all observe as far as her personality? Because we see so little of her.
Right.
The public knows very little about Elon.
And that's the funny thing. I think before this whole interview, there was this thought that she's just this ethereal creature of light and air and whatever. She's a real person, and she has emotions, and she let them come out sometimes. I mean, she's not the type to just start sobbing and crying, but you really got a feeling that she was sympathetic, and you felt for her from what she's been through.
She says this will be her one and only interview.
Yes.
Was this a paid interview?
No, it was not. And money was not her driving force in this. As we've established, she has plenty. It was more that she wanted just to get the point out there. She wanted to tell her side of the story because so much has been out there that hasn't been correct or that she's wanted to explain.
The magazine hits newsstands tomorrow. What can people expect when they flip through the pages?
Well, some pictures that have never been seen before. A lot of her talking about, you know, just her thought process. You'll actually get to know something about Elon. We know a lot more about her now than we ever knew before.
All right. Well, thanks so much for joining us, Steve, and
thanks
giving us
me.
These exclusive details. Again, the new People magazine with the exclusive interview with Elon Nordegren hits newsstands tomorrow.